could have another, but I probably should not. I got somebody at home.
Westchester University, I'm Angelica Fenori.
And I'm Emma Kiesling.
And you just saw footage from this week's Psychs After Dark. It was a glow Zumba event. Everything was LED, neon. We had two of our editors.
Tons of people there, and it looked very, very fun.
Yeah, Josh and Richard went on out, got some footage.
And they loved it.
They really put together a really cool package.
I know. I'm excited about that, and I hope they do that in the future, too.
Yeah. I mean, Emma's going to talk a little bit more about this week's Psychs After Dark, so definitely check that out. But if you want to see more of this last Psychs After Dark, check out our Facebook page. But since we know what Josh and Richard did this weekend, Emma, what did you do this weekend?
You know what? I had a pretty lax weekend.
That's good.
We had, my sorority had their chapter to retreat yesterday, and it was at Brandywine Creek Park or something.
But it was tables.
Yeah, super interesting. There was like animals there, and it was fun.
That's
it was a nice
fun.
Day. Yeah.
Mm.
What'd you do?
Well, speaking of animals, our house actually got a dog. Her name is Rue. She's really cute. She's 4 years old.
I was going to say, how old is
she?
Yeah, four.
We adopted her. She was like $1 at the SPCA, so.
Is she barking?
No, she's so chill. She's like just the most chill dog ever.
Oh my gosh, you are a parent.
I am. I'm a parent of a dog.
That's fun.
Well, we do have another packed episode with events on what's happening and going around campus. Taylor and Kristen are going to tell you all about opportunities for your organizations and student leaders to be promoted here on WCU Weekly. Amber Key will be telling us about a football player who has changed his number in honor of his friends who passed away. Lauren Alexander has our weekly weather update, and we will be hearing from Saida about how to cultivate your mind this Thursday.
Mm.
So definitely check it out.
All right, well, first, let's bring out your creativity to this Friday's Psychs After Dark, which will be featuring painting with a twist, without the twist, but get there. It's going to be super fun, and everybody comes out with really cool paintings after that. And as always, if you attend Psychs After Dark, the SAC movie is free. This week's is Jurassic World.
Did you say it?
No, but I heard it made the most money in record time at the movie theater. Yeah, really cool.
I want to see it.
Yeah, me too.
Well, the Westchester University Spanish Language Film Festival begins Wednesday, September 30th. All throughout the month until October 28th, a different film will be shown in Mitchell Hall 102 at 7:30 p.m. every Wednesday, and it's free to view. Each film will expose students to the wide range of unfamiliar realities of the Spanish-speaking world. The first film to start it off this Wednesday is about aging, and it's titled Wrinkled. So, I don't speak Spanish.
I speak a little bit, honestly.
Do you really?
Yeah, lo siento.
I have no idea what you just said.
I'm sorry. I don't know why I chose that.
Lo siento.
Lo siento.
We're just going to keep saying that throughout the episode.
I'm better at that than I am at sign language. So.
Yes.
And this Wednesday, the Frederick Douglass statue commencement ceremony will be taking place at 10:30 a.m. The ceremony will recognize the importance of social justice and civility and will feature the WCU Gospel Choir as well as many key speakers from the university. And this is the 2-year anniversary of the statue.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Being on campus, yeah. So.
Well, she is our university ambassador, so she needs to know that.
That's literally how I know that fact.
Love it. So. We should have you take us on a tour one day.
Yeah, I mean.
That's a segment idea.
That would
somebody
be really
write that
fun.
Down in the back room. Write that down. I like that idea.
We'll do that.
Now we're going to throw it over to Kristen and Taylor, who will tell us about how you can be a part of a Spotlight program and be featured on WCU Weekly.
Ooh, exciting.
Take it away, girls.
Hello, Golden Rams. Do you know of any students or organizations that should be recognized for their excellence on WCU Weekly? Submit the nomination on wcu.orgsync.com. Click on the monthly recognition tab to nominate a student for Golden Ram Rockstar or random excellence to nominate an organization.
If you want to recognize an organization or club for extraordinary work, then Random Excellence is just what you're looking for. The Spotlight provides student organizations with the opportunity to be recognized for outstanding efforts both on and off campus. Anyone can nominate clubs or organizations that they feel have displayed dedication, hard work, creativity, enthusiasm, and so much more. Every month, there will be a new group to recognize for their contribution to Westchester University and the community at large.
And each month, the Leadership Empowerment and Development team likes to showcase an individual who demonstrated outstanding leadership through various opportunities on and off campus. If you know a student who has been an outstanding leader during any month of the academic year, nominate them now. So Taylor, this seems like a great way for students to get recognized for their involvement and be featured on WCU
Weekly. Definitely. I'll have to check that out and vote for some clubs and organizations. So we're now going to learn about a football player who's honoring his friend on and off the field this season. Amber?
In his last season of his college career, Drew Formica, starting safety for the Westchester football team, hopes to play to the best of his ability and honor his new number, 24. 24 is not just a number for Formica, but it symbolizes a friendship that he will remember for the rest of his life.
Well, before my career, ended, which is now, I'm a fifth-year senior. I always wanted to wear number 24, but last year I tried to, but it was too late. So I finally got it this year to 24. I liked 42, but I always wanted to honor my friend who passed away in 2012.
Drew's childhood friend, Derek Brown, played for East Stroudsburg University before passing away due to a car accident 3 years ago.
He was in his neighborhood, and he hit a curb or something like that. I don't know if that's definitely the accurate, description of it, but his car ended up flipping, and, he didn't have a seatbelt on either, so he was in a coma for a little bit, and then ended up passing away a couple days later. And we met when we were, 11 or 12, and it was when I always used to go up to my dad's and hang out with my stepbrother. That was every other weekend I'd go to my dad's house. And when I met him, it was the first time I met him, we had this instant bond, playing football, talking about how we wanted to go to big college.
Formica remembers seeing him play as he watched from the sidelines as a redshirt, anticipating when he would finally get to play with his friend.
Definitely makes you appreciate things. It's almost after he passed away, you think about I wish I told him how much he meant to me, you know what I mean? It's kind of hard. To this day, it's hard to believe, you know what I mean?
This season, as Drew steps on the field for the last games of his career, he hopes to
do all the right things, play with passion, play with pride, give 100% effort every time. Those are qualities that he had and qualities that I've learned over time, and just seems like if you do all those three things, then good things will turn out.
Thanks, Amber. We're in for a wet week, Westchester. We can expect a chance of rain just about every day through Saturday. Hopefully, we'll see some sunshine as well. Temperatures will be mild with highs in the mid-70s and lows in the 50s throughout this week. For daily weather updates, follow the Quad on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, and Instagram, or visit us anytime online at WCUquad.com. And don't forget to pick up your issue of the Quad this week, available in newsstands all around campus. And in this week's Quad, be sure to read the article on WCU Weekly reporter Amber Key. Reporting for the Quad, I'm Lauren Alexander, and that's your weather outlook this week. Now, here's WCU Weekly reporter Saida Abbas with her report on a special yoga event happening this Thursday. Saida?
Thanks, Lauren. On Thursday, October 1st, from 1 to 4 p.m. at the Kathy McBratney Park, Cultivate Your Mind will take place for the Westchester community. As the first of many, the goal of this wellness market will be to increase the understanding of food and its importance to our mental and physical health. This event is aiming to raise awareness and transform the eating habits of students to more conscious decisions that are more sustainable. Local businesses, organizations, restaurants, clubs, groups, and co-ops will be promoting these life skills, activities, and natural traditions and remedies that aid in decreasing the symptoms of mental instability. Located on West Neal Street and South New Street, this free event will have a swap meet nature and a farmer's market vibe. Students will enjoy local and organic food, connect and share ideas, and will have the opportunity to engage in a variety of activities ranging from yoga, group meditation, live music, and slacklining and art. Parking is not guaranteed, so we encourage you to walk or bike. I'm Saida Abbas with your wellness segment. Back to you, Angelica and Emma.
Thanks, Saida. That looks like a very fun event, and it's really close by.
Right there.
And just so many different things. Have you ever done yoga before?
does it look like I could do yoga? I actually got kicked out of a yoga class once. They were like, stop talking. You're not taking this seriously enough. I was like, I'm trying.
Yeah, if you're not breathing right, they're like, no, it's got to be very particular.
Yes,
super
and I'm
hard.
Not good at that.
And all that fresh.
I can barely cross my legs. It hurts.
Well, there'll be food there. So
yeah,
I think
so I'll just handle the food section.
That's good stuff. And maybe you could bring the pop along.
Yes. So keep an eye out for us in Rue. Well, that concludes this episode of WCU Weekly. As always, if you have anything you would like to be read on air or would like to get involved with WCU Weekly, be sure to email us at wcuweekly@wcupa.edu.
And be sure to follow us on Facebook for segments, events, and much more.
Until next week, I'm Angelica Fenori.
And I'm Emma Kiesling.
Have a great week, Westchester University.
And an even better weekend. We're cool for the summer. We'll be right back.